Endocrine system. Endocrine system consists of ductless glands that produce chemical messengers known as hormones. In this video, we will learn the anatomy of the endocrine glands. Pituitary gland. It is otherwise known as the master endocrine gland that is situated in the hypophyseal fossa of the sphenoid bone, below the hypothalamus, and it is attached to the hypothalamus by a stalk, and they function together as a unit. It is just the size of a pea and weighs around 500 milligrams. There are two main parts or lobes of the pituitary gland, that is the anterior and the posterior pituitary. They differ greatly in structure and function. The anterior pituitary is also known as the adenohypophysis because it is originated from the upgrowth of glandular epithelium from the pharynx. The posterior pituitary is also known as the neurohypophysis because it originates from the downgrowth of nervous tissue from brain. Blood supply. It is supplied by the branches of internal carotid artery, and venous return is by the short veins that drain into venous sinuses between the dura mater. A network of capillaries known as the pituitary portal system connects the hypothalamus and pituitary gland. The thyroid gland. The thyroid gland is located at the neck in front of the trachea just below the larynx at the level of C5 to T1. That is between the 5th cervical and 1st thoracic vertebrae. They are butterfly shaped, having two lobes connected by an isthmus. The lobes are cone shaped and measure 5 cm long and 3 cm wide. They are highly vascular, surrounded by a fibrous capsule and weighs 25 grams. Blood supply, it is supplied by the superior and inferior thyroid arteries. Venous return is by the thyroid veins, which drains into the internal jugular vein. It is supplied by the laryngeal nerves. The pancreas. The exocrine pancreas secretes enzymes for digestion. Specialized cells called the islets of Langerhans or pancreatic islets are scattered throughout the pancreas like islands, and they produce hormones. There are three types of cells in the islets of pancreas: alpha, beta and delta cells. Adrenal glands. They are so named because they are situated near the kidneys. Also called the suprarenal glands because they are located on the upper pole of each kidney. They are enclosed within the renal fascia and are 4 cm long and 3 cm thick. They have two parts, the outer cortex and the inner medulla. Blood supply, they are supplied by the branches from the abdominal aorta and renal arteries. Venous return is by the suprarenal veins that is drained into inferior venae cava. The thymus gland lies in the upper part of the mediastinum, behind the sternum, and extends till the root of the neck. Weighs about 10 to 15 gram at birth. It weighs the maximum at puberty and reaches 30 to 40 gram. After that, it is atrophied and returns back to the weight at birth by the middle age. It has two lobes joined by areolar tissue. The lobes are enclosed in fibrous capsule, and this capsule dips into the lobules and divides them further into lobules. The anatomy of testicles and ovaries will be discussed in the anatomy of reproductive system. This is just an overview of the anatomy of endocrine system. In the next video, we'll see the physiology of endocrine system. So stay tuned and consider subscribing. Thank you.